So to set the trap, you're just gonna walk to the edge of the water at low tide. And we have our plastic bait container. You can fill it with whatever kind of bait you want, but we usually use tuna. You drop it into one part of the modified minnow trap. And you have these two different hook systems. And to close the trap, you'll just put each hook into the slot and close it. Then there's a clip right here. You can clip through both hooks and turn it to make sure it's secure. And that's how you put together the trap. Then what you're gonna wanna do, get right at the water's edge, and you could place the trap right down, but we found best success with making a little divot for the trap so that it just stays in one place and securing it. For the trap, try not to hit any rocks, and you go as deep as you can. Lots of rocks here, but you would typically go as deep as you can, getting like this far into the ground, just so that during a higher tide the trap won't roll around. Then you'll leave, and when the tide gets higher, water will wash over your trap and it'll hopefully fill with green crabs. You can come back the next day at low tide again and pick it up, and you should have lots of green crabs. So then after your 24-hour period, you can come back, pick up your trap, take the stake out, and you will have lots of crabs in here, hopefully. You can just undo the trap, and usually there'll be crabs in here, so you'll have to be careful that they're not falling out. And if you have a bucket, you can pour your green crabs into the bucket. And if you catch anything other than a green crab, we ask that you return those to the water since they are native here.
Here are two green crabs that we've trapped. So as you can see, they're called European green crabs, but they can have coloring that's green, yellow, or even orange. The telltale sign that you're gonna look for to identify them are the five spines around their eyes. So as you can see, here are their two eyes, and these little triangles next to the eyes are the spines.
I think the most challenging part of working with the green crabs is predicting where they're going to be. You know, some sites you'll have lots of green crabs, other sites you won't, and you really don't know until you get out there and just start trapping them. Know about where green crabs are in Coos Bay and how many there are, we can try to predict management practices a little bit better. And how people can get involved is if you see a green crab, you know, they're invasive, so please remove them from the water.